Thank you for here tonight. Crazy day. We began the service here this morning with heat, but now we got air conditioning all on the same day. Go figure that one out. So let's have a word of prayer and then we'll start. Lord, we thank you that we've gathered this evening. I pray you'll bless those who are sharing my song and just make this a good time that we can draw close to you, Lord. In your name we pray. Amen.
And a flannel shirt on this morning. Now I got a short sleeve shirt. The God bless America again. You have to admit, you've seen all the troubles that she did. Watch her pretty face, try to hide the man. God bless America again. Now sing with me, all of you sing. This land is yours.
Lord, let my eyes see every need. walk through this world with me. I've told this story, probably everybody heard it. This is a George Jones song, and it doesn't say who he's asking to walk through the world with him. And so I'm assuming when I'm playing in church that he's asking Jesus to walk with him. So we'll give it a shot.
Yeah, G.
Walk through this world with me. Go where I go. Share all my dreams with me. I need to show if God was
it's
been too long.
Because I tried unplugging every one this afternoon. I was here a couple hours messing with it. I unplugged them and still come through the open. Well, sing loud, you won't notice it.
All righty. This is a lighthouse, King C. There's a lighthouse on the hillside that overlooks life's sea. When I toss, it stands out of the light that I might see. And the light that shines in darkness now will safely lead us home. If it wasn't for the lighthouse, my ship would be no more. It seems that everyone about us says tear that lighthouse down. The big ships don't pass this way anymore. There's no use in it standing round. Then my mind goes back to that stormy night when just in time I saw the light from that old lighthouse that stands upon the hill. And I thank God for the lighthouse I owe my life to live. Jesus is the lighthouse, and from the rocks He has shown the light around me that I might clearly see. If it wasn't for the lighthouse, tell me where the wish would be. Thank you.
remember when I was a lad, times were hard and things were bad. There was silver lining behind every fire. Just poor people is all we were, try to make a living out of my labor. We all get together with a family circle and we're ready, Alice. Daddy sang bass.
Thank you. Good job.
Yeah. I like that last song.
that? Don't you coffee over?
This first song I'm going to do is a song that everybody knows, and you probably learned it as a child. That's when I learned it. And I want everybody to sing it with me, okay? It's called Jesus Loves Me.
Oh, yeah.
We're in D, and then the second, third verse we're going to change to E. Jam, and I started writing this song, and I only got about halfway done, and I guess maybe a couple of verses and a chorus. When I got there, I thought maybe, well, during break time, I can finish it. So at break time, I just got out the song, and it was just on a piece of scrap paper, because when the words come to me, I gotta write them down right then. So I'm writing, I'm thinking, and I'm praying, okay, Lord, what do you want me to put now? What do you want me to say? What do you want me to say? There was so much confusion going around that I was distracted, and I couldn't hear the Lord speaking to me if he was talking to me. So I said, okay, well, I'll just, I'll put it in my bag, and I'll go home, and I'll finish when God tells me to give me some more words, because that's how I write. I don't write on my own. But so I get home, and I go to pull it out so I can have it nearby, and it wasn't there. And I'm looking everywhere. I'm looking through my book. I'm looking through the book bag. I'm looking on the floor. I called up the guy who lives there, and I said, look, would you look around where I was sitting and see if there's a piece of paper down there that I dropped? It's a song that I started to write. And he looked everywhere. It wasn't there. He looked in the trash. He looked everywhere, tore the place apart. It wasn't there. So I said, okay, Lord, I'm not going to get upset. I'm just going to say, you know, I'll finish it whenever, if you want me to write it, it'll be finished. So when you just show it to me, and wherever it is, I'll find it. And I kept saying, Lord, I'm not going to get upset. Just show me where it is, you know, and I couldn't find it. And I looked everywhere. So anyway, I said, okay, Lord, it's all in your time, and I'm going to leave it up to you. So I went upstairs to my bedroom, and I was going to change my clothes. And lo and behold, this scrap of paper was sitting on my makeup stand. I never took it up there. It was a God thing. I don't know why, but God gave me the song back, and I don't know why it ended up there, what he was trying to say, but I said, oh, thank you, Lord, thank you, thank you, thank you, and I was so excited. So anyway, I finished the song, and this is the song. So it's called Let Jesus Take You There, and it's just kind of like an easygoing, kind of funny song, and I think we can all relate to it. It's called Let Jesus Take You There. Thank you. Body hurts every But anyway, this is another song that I wrote. When I got saved, I went to the Pocono Mountains with the Methodist Church, and it was such an exciting time for me, but I didn't really meet the Lord until the last day we were supposed to leave. And so God gave me this song right in the middle of Walmart. I started writing down and singing the chorus. So anyway, this song is called The Mountain. G. Protesting and all the people that are lost and all the people that have no clue and what's coming after the Christians are gone, you know, I pray for them because they're really going to be left behind and they're really going to be surprised and have a hard time through it because the Bible says it's going to be horrible, horrible things, tribulation period. So anyway, I kind of hold back on that, Lord, take me home. But he'll take me home when he's ready for me. When my mansion's finished up there, he'll take me home. Amen. So wait a little longer, please, Jesus. PJ. Wait.
Where's the blue gym?
Anyway, before you get up, would you sing my song?
Which one?
And then stop dancing.
If I can remember the words.
Oh, you don't remember the words.
I don't have my capo. No, next time.
You can use my capo. That's
no. I don't know if I can remember the words. I could try. This is in, where is it? A and B flat, I forget.
Okay.
Huh?
A. B flat.
A flat to B flat.
Greek to me without your capo.
I'll remember it when I get down there and see. I don't know. I'm sorry. I don't remember.
Okay.
I'm crippled without my words.
Next month.
Make sure you come next month. All right, Ed. Come on back. Oh, no.
Louis Jim's
coming up.
I don't know where they want to sit, stand, or what.
Sit. You got chairs?
Yeah, come on up. Sure.
Easier to sit than move them.
Can you use these two chairs, or do you want me to move?
That's good. That's good. Super job.
Thank you.
Stop singing. The static starts.
Yes.
Hello.
I'm just gonna take one, but.
Yeah, I know. But if me and Don got up, it'd take us to 9 o'clock.
Oh, that's good. Did you send them to me? I gotta put these. Oh, okay. Oh, that's good. If I'm gonna do them or not, and what hours. Okay.
You can sit.
You sure?
Yeah.
Can you play with something?
If I die, I'll just float on up.
Okay. Need a basement.
Yeah, I'm going to take some. I really thought I was going to go there for a while.
Yes, I had that.
Oh, my goodness. Mm-hmm. I don't usually sit.
Like harnessing up the old horse.
Looking around, I don't think anybody has to go to work tomorrow. Is that a dirty thing to say?
I gotta do work.
Huh?
For myself.
No, oh, yeah. You know what to me.
You got that. You're close to that.
I have more work now than I did when I worked.
Yeah. Well, I admit I do a whole lot more sleeping than I used to do when I worked.
Not me, I just sit in the chair in the afternoon.
Oh,
go to sleep.
We're going to try one I don't think we've ever done here. We did it at Jimmy's. You liked it.
You did.
God on the Mountain?
Yeah.
What was it?
God on the Mountain?
God on the Mountain.
God on the Mountain. You know
what? Yeah, they come over to my house every Tuesday. We jam.
We don't have one.
And Jim brought his son this past Tuesday. His son does great.
Yeah.
He tries.
We need some youth.
He's a good teacher. What key
is
it?
G. And I'm singing the lead. Life is easy.
Dawn thinks it's his guitar.
I know, but it isn't.
Okay, this one, not even plugged in, I think it's just a guitar.
We got one for Pastor. You ready?
This is entitled The Box Seat in Heaven. If our voice holds up.
That was the box seat in Baltimore.
Oh,
think it would have been the last song we just did. We've never done that before.
That was a good song. I like that.
I'm going to stay in my eyes. I got to very close if I can see it.
I hate this game.
Pretty impressive, all these mics and cords, though.
The same ones, they're just all jumbled together.
When a church has that, it looks like they're more, you know.
Well, I spread them out last time, and I had too many people didn't like it. I have all the way across, you know. So I jammed everybody back together.
I don't worry about that stuff, but everyone does fine with me. Too many other things to worry about than brother, you know. Anyway, Psalm 1:1-3. Blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, or stand in the ways of the sinners, or sit in the seat of the mockers. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and on his law he meditates day and night. He's like a tree planted by waters, streams of waters, which yields its fruit in season, whose leaves does not wither, wherever he does prosper. And the third verse is saying the reason it prospers is by the source of water. And does that tell us that we need to be our source of power, and that is Jesus Christ? I love this time of year as the trees start to change. About a week or so ago, I was driving to Baltimore, and as you got near into Maryland, the trees were bloom. Now, all of a sudden, ours are blooming. And it's fascinating to me how it can look so dead and all of a sudden it just blooms. The creation of this world is amazing. That's why it says, the fool says there is no God. How do you think it just popped into existence? That's impossible. There has to be a grand designer, and that's the Lord. But trees are fascinating things. So I want to look at four traits of trees. So next time you see a tree in the daylight, when it'll be dark when you get out of here, I want you to think about what I said tonight about a tree. There's four traits of trees do. They go upward, downward, inward, and outward. So Ephesians 4:15 says, rather speaking the truth in love, we are to grow up in every way into him who is the head, Jesus Christ. A tree grows upward. It has to be. I remember my Uncle Eddie planted a peach tree where he lived in Levittown. He was one of the first when they opened Levittown, Pennsylvania. And he put this tree in the yard. It was about this tall. And he said, well, we're going to have peaches. He says, on that scrawny thing. But as time went on, the tree got bigger, upward and upward. And believe it or not, that tree yielded a lot of peaches. And really good peaches, too. And my aunt gave some to my grandmother, who made the best peach pie ever in the existence of the world, and now she's gone at that point. But you grow up. Have you ever said sometimes to your kids, when are you going to grow up? Sometimes women say to their husbands, when are you going to grow up? And we should mature. It's nice to say that on a certain day, I became a Christian. I like the people that can say, on such a month, day, hour, I brought a Christ in my life. I can't really tell you. I can tell you how old I was. I'm not impressed with that. What I want to know is, have you grown since the day you invited Christ into your life? Grow up towards spiritual maturity. A tree grows downward. Ephesians 3:17 says, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you being rooted and grounded in love. A tree must grow upward, but it has to have a root system. We had a lot of rain here for a while, and you see a lot of trees laying over on the side. As it rains, the root system is not real good. My house in Mickleton we bought 3 years ago, it was surrounded by trees. You could not see out any window except the front. There was 18 trees surrounding this house, tall. I chopped them all down with a handsaw. It took me about a week. And then took a truck and we pulled them out. And they came out of the ground so easy because the root system wasn't very good. We as Christians need to be grounded in the Lord. Now I think of a palm tree. First time I ever saw a palm tree, other than a photograph, was when I was in the Navy. And my job was we would have airplanes fly places, and my job was to go out there with a crew and we would fix any downed aircraft. So we're going to go to Yuma, Arizona. And that's the first time I saw a palm tree. And how can they grow? It's amazing. Well, when I was over in Bahrain in the Persian Gulf, I got a free vacation by the Navy during the Gulf War. expenses paid. And they took me out with this called, it's called the Tree of Life. And that tree, it would be bigger than this church building right here. It was huge. But there's nothing around it. All desert. How does that tree survive? But I'm told it had one of the most extensive root systems. And a palm tree, by the way, also has a very extensive root system. And it has to in order to survive in some of the toughest places. A palm tree could be in a place very hot. And the Persian Gulf is where I got there in June. It was 105 degrees in the morning. Great place to be. But how does this stuff survive? But it goes down deep enough, it gets its nourishment. So we, like the palm tree, need to be grounded in the Lord. And how do we do that? Keep your prayer life up, read your Bible, that's what you have to do, to be grounded in the Lord. So we're rooted in the Lord. A tree goes inward. 2 Peter 3:18 says, but grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. If we look at a tree, we need to know what's the inside of it. Now, right where I live off of King's Highway, there was this huge tree. I mean, it was a big tree. And it always looked all right. And then we had a storm, and over it went. And I thought, wow, that tree just, they were cutting it all up. But I walked down there later to see, how could that tree come down? It just broke. But when I got down to look at it, the inside of it was all rotted. It looked good on, you know what I'm talking about, that big tree. You see, if the inside isn't right, it can look good on the outside. Now, I know this doesn't apply to anybody here, but there are people who profess to be a Christian and say Christian things and do good deeds, but what's on the inside? We look at the outside of a person, but one day you'll stand before the Lord on Judgment Day, and that's a fact, that comes right out of Scripture, and the Lord's going to not care what you look like, what you're wearing, but what's on the inside? What is the condition of your heart? That's what's very important. The inner person, that's what has to happen. And like I say, when these hurricanes come and tornadoes and the weather's just all over the place. It's crazy. You know what? It's not normal anymore. It used to be, you know, we left the Kansas City area to go to Ohio. And then next thing you know, they were getting tornadoes in Ohio. And then I thought, we're going to move to New Jersey. We don't have to worry about tornadoes. Now they come. I was so afraid that when the tornado came in 3 miles of my house, living in Kansas all those years, and my house gets destroyed by a tornado in New Jersey. But you could definitely see, and I was just saying when we were riding today to go to a soccer game with my grandson, there's places you go, you can see all the trees still laying over. It's never going to look pretty again. They're going to be there when I'm all gone. But they can only clean up so much. But all these trees just fell over, and all you do is see the root system. So make sure that you are rooted in the Lord, and that your inward person is really where you should be with the Lord. And lastly, a tree goes outward, spreads out.
That's the tree.
There we go. Tree branches go outward and go in all directions. And what that says to me in our Christian life, we need to be reaching out like a tree branch to touch those around us. We need to reach out with kindness, understanding, and compassion, for the world really needs it. I, in my soon-to-be 76 years of life, and I was telling my son, we had lunch the other day, and he said, what do you think, Pop, the way things are? I said, all my life, I have never seen this country so divided between government, religious systems. It's chaotic. And he says, what kind of future will my children have? I said, well, on this planet, not so good maybe. But I'll tell you one thing, and I'm really proud of all my sons are Christians, and I'm so glad, and they're raising their families in Christian faith. And I'm so glad for that, because I'll tell you what, what's going to eventually happen is, maybe you won't have it here, but you're right about that mansion, Linda, that's very true. What awaits us on the other side is going to be something really great. But just remember, though, so next time you see a tree, even pull over and look at it. And say to yourself, am I growing upward, downward, inward, and outward? Because that's what we need to do. Grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And I don't know about you, but I've not arrived at my Christian faith yet. I still need growth, and Lord knows I need a lot of it at times. But you know what? I believe this. I believe everything that's happening, all the crazy things, the weather, everything's just really strange. Did you ever think that God is giving us a warning? And what's happening in Israel, what's happening around the world, and I really believe this, God is saying, look, folks, you better listen up. And I think the signs are here. And I know years ago, people would predict, I mean, you go back to World War II, and they thought Hitler was the Antichrist. But I think now is a little bit different. Because I was born in 1948. You know what happened in 1948? Israel became a nation. And the Bible says, and it predicted, that one day, Israel would go back to their homeland, their promised land. It also said, this generation will not pass away. I'm going to live to be 100. Maybe on my 99th birthday, the Lord will come back. But I really believe, folks, we need to pray. We need to reach out to people. Because I think the coming of the Lord is going to be here sooner than we think. So God bless you all. And you pray for me, and I'll sure pray for you. Thanks for not messing up here. Thank you. Now we're going to take the offering before I plate.
I thought maybe you forget.
I'm going inside. No, that's... We went to seminary, don't do a service without the offering plate.
The hats are over there, Bob.
Well, the hats are, you guys see one plate. There we go.
We need a bigger church.
Okay. Here we go. We'll start over here. And then this one. Okay.
We're here.
All right.
Thank you.
Blessing for our fellowship next door. Bless the refreshments. And most of all, Lord, thank you for your many blessings. In your name we pray, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. See you next month after we have refreshments next